Hey, what's up guys? In this video we are going to cover the Node.js core modules and specifically the file system module in the Node.js. So first of all, what we will do, we'll learn about what are Node.js core modules. So I will explain what are Node.js core modules and how we can import them into our file system or into our files, and how can we use the file system module. We will learn what are different things. What are these different node modules, which are HTTP, URL, path, file system, util in this play series or in this playlist. I will explain all of these things, and in this video specifically we will focus on the file system module. So the agenda of this video is that first of all we will learn what are Node.js core modules, and in the second step we will learn how to create a new file with file system module. We will import the file system module from Node.js because it comes from the Node.js when we install it. And in the second step we have done this, and then in the third step we will learn when we have created a file from our code, how can we add a content to that file. You will learn it when I will write a code. This is just a demo what we are going to do in this video. So in the next step we will learn how to append the content to the existing file. The next thing is going to be how to read this created file, the file that we have created with the our file system module. How can we read the data from it, and the data we will get is the buffer data. So what is the buffer data, and then we will learn how to convert this buffer data into the readable data. So first of all, what is Node.js core modules? So basically the core modules of Node, such as a file system, HTTP, these comes from the Node.js when we install Node.js. So in this video specifically we will discuss the file system module, and in the later videos we will discuss different of the these modules. So what is file system modules? File system module contain classes, methods and events to work with the file input and output. So let's write a code, and in this way you will learn a better way. So first of all I will import a file system module with the name of fs. So we will use require fs. So this is the syntax to import any of the Node.js core modules. Now the first thing that we want to do is we want to create a new file with this Node.js module. So for this we will use a fs dot. Now when I will write a dot, you will see we have a lot of options which file system module support. We can use different of the methods that we want. Now in this video what I want to do is I want to create a file. So what I want to do is, so let's create a file. We can use different methods that come with the Node.js. So let's write a file. So it is going to be fs.create, or we can say write file sync. So we have different methods, which is the write file sync and the async method. We are going to use the sync method in this video. So let's use fs.write file sync, and what it will do, it will, we have to provide a path where we want to create, or the name of the file that we want to create. So for example I will give it a name of some name such as arslan.txt, and the next thing that we want to do is we want to give it some content. So the content that has been, that will add to this created file. So let's give it a content of hi, how are you. Now what I will do, I will save it and I will open the terminal, and with the help of node I will run this file. So let's run it, which will be node, and the name of our file which will be index.js. Now you will see when we have run this code, our file is created, which is our sound.txt, and when I will open this file you will see the content that I have added it in it. So now you will see the content that I have added is successfully created in this file. So we have learned how to create a file with the help of Node.js core modules, which is the file system, and we have also learned how we can add a content in it. So the second step is completed. The third step is going to be how to add content to this created file which has already been created added. Now the next step is how to append the content to the existing file. So let's say our existing file is this one, and we want to add we want to append some content in it. We don't want to replace it. So if you want to replace it, you can run this code again. So for example, if I will add some another content and I will run it, you will you can see it will replace it. So let's test it. Hi, how are you? What's going on? Now when I will run this code, you will see all of the previous content will be replaced by the new one. So as you will see, all of the previous content has been replaced by the new one. But what we want to do is we just want to append the content in it. We don't want to replace the content. So for this, let's comment this line. And now what I want to do is I want to append the content to this file. So for this, I will use a file system and I will use append file sync. We are using the synchronous version in this. You can also use the async, but we are focusing on the synchronous version right now. So what this will do is it will contain the path for which we want to append the content, and the next thing is going to be the content that I want to add. So let's see the now the content that is present right now is saying hi, how are you, what's going on. So for example, what I want to add is subscribe to this YouTube channel. So let's add, first of all give it a space, then I will write subscribe to my YouTube channel. Let's save it, and now when I will run this code, you will see this content will not be replaced. Instead, this content will be appended to this file. So let's run the code again. So let's see. Now you will see our code has been run successfully, in which we have learned how we can append the content to the file that we have created with the file system module. Now you will see it's successfully showing subscribe to my YouTube channel, and it's the code the content has been appended to it. Now we have learned two different things, which are how to create a file, how we can add the content to it, and now we have learned how we can append the content to the content that is already present. So the next step is going to be we have created a content. Now we want to read it from our file. So the file system also has a module for this. So let's say we want to read the content. So for this we will use read file sync. So let's give the name of the file. It will return the buffer data. So the data that it will be returned, we want to store it into the variable. So it's going to be the buffer underscore data. The data that will be returned will be stored in this variable, which is the buffer data. So let's console.log this, and we will see in the terminal what it will return. So let's save it and clear the terminal and run the code again. Now you will see we are receiving this data. So as you will see, we are receiving this data and it is not readable, and we can't understand what's going on here. So what is buffer data? I will explain it. Let me copy some text from here. So I will paste it here. Now you will see what is this buffer data. Let's comment this buffer data also. So Node.js includes an additional data type called buffer. It is not available in browser JavaScript. So this buffer data feature is not available in the browser JavaScript that we use in the front end. So it's specifically present for the back end, for our server side coding. Now buffer is mainly used to store the binary data. So as you can see, these are the binary numbers, and it will store the data in the binary form while reading from a file or receiving packets over the network. So this is the way buffer data work. When we read file, we receive the data in the form of a buffer, and then we convert it into the readable form. So I hope you have learned what is the buffer data. Now what we will do is we will convert it into the readable form. So it will be very easy one, it will not be difficult one. So let's comment it out. And now what I want to do, I will create a variable which is the readable data, and then I will convert this buffer data to string. So this will be a function to convert the this buffer data into the readable form. And then what I will do is I will log it, and it will be readable underscore data. So let's see what is the data that we are getting. Clear the console, run the code. Now you see we have converted this buffer data into the readable form, and we have stored this data in the readable data, and then we have console.log this readable data. And now you are saying seeing in the terminal that we are getting a readable data which is saying, hi, how are you, what's going on, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Now you have seen all of these steps, which are what is the buffer data, you have understood what is the buffer data and how we can convert this buffer data into the readable form. So these are the steps that I want to cover in this file system video. There will be a lot of videos that will be coming in this playlist, and gradually we will move into the difficult topics and in the projects later. So this is the start of this playlist of the complete Master Node.js course. So follow this series if you want to learn Node.js, because we will cover all of the topics in the Node.js. And in the later part, when we will cover the Node.js, we will also going to cover Express.js and MongoDB. So I hope you have learned something from this, and don't forget to like the video, subscribe to this channel, and also tell me in the comments what kind of videos you want in the future. I have also created a playlist for different JavaScript projects and also data structures and algorithms, and I create videos about all of these things. And now this playlist or this Node.js course will cover all of the things that you need to get started with Node.js. So have a nice day. This is the end of this tutorial.